Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. I hope everybody is doing great. So today we are live with mock interviews. We have two panelists with us. First of all, I would like to introduce to our first interview, that is Maryam Mustaq. Maryam is Executive Human Resource at Altista Garment Industries Private Limited. She has been associated with that company and is working as an executive. She has also work in other organizations like FMCG's textile and manufacturing. Our another second interviewer for today is Shehzad Nasir. He is Human Resource Executive at Artistic Denim Mills Limited. Shehzad is also associated with different organizations before that, and currently he's executive at Denim Mills. And he is skilled in recruitment, talent acquisition, training need assessment, event organizing, business planning, operations management, and customer services. So this is it for our introduction for the interviewers. So let's proceed further towards our mock interviews.
Assalamu alaikum and good morning.
Walaikum assalam.
How are you, ma'am?
Am I audible, ma'am? Alhamdulillah, I'm fine, ma'am. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Okay, Mavish, please introduce yourself.
Okay, so I was born in Hyderabad and I have done my matriculation from Army Public School, MSG Lahore, Kent. And I have done my intermediate from Army Public College, Faisal, Karachi. And currently, I'm doing BBA from DHS of a university with the CGP of 3.4 out of 4. And I have been into different places. I have done my internship at DHA head office. And that internship was before choosing my major. So I was very confused at which major I should opt for. So I did my internship at DHA head office in PR department, as they don't have any proper marketing department. I asked them and they said that we are not selling any kind of product. So they are just dealing with land and this thing. So through this, my experience, and as my father, he has also served 30 years in army. So I've been into different places. So I love to make like new friends. I love to interact with different people. I love to socializing a lot. So through this personal and professional experience, I just opt for like marketing. So my major, I'm doing majors in marketing.
You worked as a sales executive as well at the Future Power Company, or it was an internship?
Yes, ma'am. It was an internship. Internship.
What did you learn from your internship?
I did a lot of things from this internship. Like I have to do this internship by sitting at my home. So they just provided me their emails, their like contact numbers of all the customers who are living in residential and commercial area of only Karachi. So what I just have to do is email them and tell them about our company, like we are selling these and this product. If you want to like buy this product, you can contact me. So I learn how to do direct marketing through emails and through messages. So, yeah.
Okay. Mavish, have you studied about our company?
Your company?
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. I do.
Okay. What marketing strategies do you think we should follow since we are an export-oriented organization?
Yeah. So, I think... it depends basically on your company. Like you are dealing with your manufactured products, denim and garments like that. So it basically depends on the products that like you are selling premium products. So you just need to more on as I never heard before about your company that it exists. Maybe I don't know why, but I didn't knew about your company before. So I think it should be more they should more do marketing on social media as well. Young generation is mobile savvy. They spend a lot of their time on Facebook, Instagram, and like that. So I think you should go for social media as well.
And okay. Do you know about international brands? that you work with?
Ma'am, you?
Yes.
I have just studied about you are not only operating in Pakistan, you are also operating in other countries as well, but not in depth about products and like that.
Okay, fair enough. In marketing, in which section would you be interested to work in?
I am basically interested in two fields. Like one is I have my experience in PR department, personal relation, and I also love to do in digital marketing. And third one is sales. So on the basis of my past experience, I will go for if I have an opportunity that which field you can choose. So I will opt from these three fields.
Are tools used in digital marketing?
Yes, ma'am.
What are the different tools used in digital marketing?
For digital marketing, we use
digital marketing.
Yeah, for digital marketing, we can use Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and WhatsApp, Snapchat, all these tools we can use for digital marketing.
Okay, and what sort of different advertising that we can use?
There are different types of marketing tools are there. It basically depends that you want to advertise your product inbound or outbound. So it depends. Like for inbound, you can use banners. Standees and all these things. But if you want to go for outbound advertising, you can use, you can see that there are billboards are there, there are social media and all these things are there. So these are the tools which you can use for advertisement.
Connecting this to our organization, what would be more suitable method to use for advertising for our organization?
For your organization, as previously I have mentioned that for your organization, I think the best thing is that you should go for digital marketing. You should go for digital marketing as we are those person who basically love to we basically know about the products through social media. Usually we don't spend our time on watching televisions and all traditional methods of advertisement. We don't usually read books and other things. We don't see brochures and something like that. So I think you should opt for digital marketing.
Okay, Shehzad, please.
Yes, Ms. Mavish, please differentiate between the marketing and sales. What is the difference between marketing and sales?
Okay, so basically there's a difference between marketing and sales. Marketing is a vast, field, and sales comes under marketing. Okay, so in marketing is not only about how you're going to sell this product, buying it. It's not only about buying and selling a product. It's about how you are going to fulfill the needs of the customer, how you will going to recognize the need of the customer, and how you will come up with better solution for them, and how you will going to maintain a long relationship and retain for a longer period of time. And sales is basically about, now it's also depends that you are a sales manager or sales representative, and there are different types of sales. So sales basically, if I'm a salesperson, so salesperson basically deals with selling of product. They were going to maintain a relationship with the customer, and he will find out that who is my target customer, and how I will going to pitch in front of them so that they will more interested toward my product and towards my deal.
What is the best strategy using in Pakistan marketing?
In marketing,
best strategy in marketing, using in Pakistan.
Present strategy is the best strategy for Pakistan is digital marketing, and in digital marketing there you can see that due to COVID-19 and different things, people are moving towards digital marketing, and they are moving towards Facebook, social media, and all that things. And also they can also advertise, they are also putting a lot of efforts on television advertisement as well.
Ms. Tasin, over from my side.
All right. Thank you, Mavish. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Take care, Lafiz.
Thank you, Ms. Mahesh. Take care, Lafiz.
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 All right, then. Now we have Hera. Hera will be joining.
Okay.
Good morning.
Assalamu alaikum.
Salman, please unmute your mic.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Wa alaikum assalam.
How are you, Salman?
I'm fine. What about you?
I'm fine, thank you. Please introduce yourself.
I am Mohammad Salman Akhtar and I'm doing BBA in finance from BHS Hopa University.
Okay.
And I'm wanted to working in finance sector.
Okay. Tell me about your work experiences as an intern and your current work experience as a tutor.
Yes, I am giving tuitions to online and physical as well.
What and sort of courses are you teaching?
Accounting.
Okay. And to which students?
9th standard and 10th standard.
Okay. Okay. What about your internship experiences?
In 2018, I have done internship in DHS, DHS head office in finance department.
Okay.
And I also done internship in Crown Motors company.
Okay. What tasks did they assign you?
In Crown Motors, I am in receivable section. So my task is that to reconcile the ledgers of the distributors.
Okay. What are the difference between accounts payable and accounts receivable?
Account receivable, those things which we have covered, the funds from our distributors and jo bhi humne loan diya hua, wo cover karna. And in payable, what amount we have to pay to our vendors. And in if we take loan from banks, so it's also come in account payable.
Okay. And where they are recorded in the balance sheet?
In liability sections, we recorded account payable. And in asset sections, we record the account receivable.
Okay. And what is the bank reconciliation?
In bank reconciliations, we have to checking the balance, what we have recorded in our checkbooks and what's the bank showing us.
So what sort of errors do we discover?
We check the accountant problem or the bank problem. If the error, so we will do it correct.
Kis type ke errors identify ho sakte? Just name a few.
For example, typo error. For example, we have given the check of 250 and we have write 2500 or like this.
Theek hai. You have worked on the ERP software as well?
Yes, in Ground Refan, I have done. I am all working in done the ERP system.
Kis type ki entries uspe kar rahe the software pe?
General entries hone ke baad, uske baad general ledger ban jata tha khud hi, aur phir usko hum Excel sheet se reconcile karte the.
Theek hai. Excel sheet pe, how good are you in terms of if you rate out of 10?
7.5.
Any idea about VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, pivot table?
No idea, but I am comfortable in doing Excel.
ठीक है. Finance में भी there are different sections. So which section would you be interested in?
In account receivable.
Account receivable. ठीक है.
Yes.
ठीक है. Shahzad, please.
Yes. Mr. Salman, how would you calculate asset depreciation?
There we have 2-3 methods. Firstly, many companies are using straight line methods, double decline method, and ages of the equipment.
Okay. Asset depreciation jo hai aapka credit mein jayega ya debit mein entry hogi iski?
Debit mein.
Asset depreciation aapka debited mein aayega ya credited mein aayega?
Credit mein aayega.
ट्रेड में आएगा
क्या अमाउंट उसकी? जी
ठीक है ठीक है ठीक है. सिंह, थैंक यू सो मच मिस्टर सलमान.
Thank you.
Okay.
Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz.
All right. Thank you, Salman. Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz.
1 minute.
Okay. We have Hani with us. Hani Baloch.
Okay.
We are just left with two candidates. One is not joining today because he is stuck in on the road because of this
traffic.
Yeah. Jo block hua hai, traffic and block hua hai sare roads, so he's stuck over there.
Okay, no issues.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Hani, how are you?
I'm fine. Okay. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Please introduce yourself.
I'm Hani Baloch and I'm currently doing my bachelor's from DHS Ufa University in the majors of supply chain. Okay. And I have done my HR internship in the DHA head office. And okay. I also work as a freelancer. Okay. And I have completed different online courses from different portals, which okay. have helped me in my vital subject to learn and gain about it more.
Okay. As a freelancer, you did mention that you managed HR and business assessment. So what was that about?
It was about the projects were related to different related to the HR courses. Like I got this project that had some HR related questions and assignments that was given on it, or the task was given on this assignment. So I had to do the analysis of it, which I have mentioned. So most of the assignments that I get is of HR and the supply chain.
Okay. So what do you think, Hani, is the supply chain processes?
Ma'am, supply chain is basically the management of the flow of goods and services along with the process that transforms the raw material into finished good. Like for example, there's this cake shop and it has a demand of cake from the customer. So it would it would have a backward integration. Like the manufacturers will it will request the manufacturers, and manufacturers will request the supplier to supply the raw materials like the required for the product, and in manufacture sector the production will take place, and it will be forwarded towards the distributors, and distributor will distribute it to retailers where the customers can get the product. So this is the whole supply chain process.
Okay. What is vertical integration?
Vertical integration is like you have gain on your suppliers and your backward. It's kind of a backward integration.
Okay, connecting the process with our organization. So, what do you think would be this? Our process of supply chain?
As I've studied on your, like I read on your website, process is like it had departments, like units, like it has spinning, weaving, and after that, it's dyeing, and after weaving, and after that, it's spinning, and after the whole process, it's checking the quality of the product. So where in dyeing, the product comes and it dies, and after the whole process takes place.
So
and
how supply chain plays its part?
Supply chain plays its parts in a way like it provides the material, the fabric that is required, the material, the cotton, the fabric that is being required to make the product. Supply chain plays a role in it.
Just this part, or there's other part that's going to be played in the other processes?
For quality control, like quality control is a part of supply chain. So quality control is a part of supply chain. So it also plays the role in the supply chain.
How quality control plays its part in supply chain?
to after making of the product, like we have studied in our majors, like after the product is being made in the production process. So the product is being, after the development of the production of the product, it is being checked whether the quality of the product is is up to the mark or not. If not, then the custom, if it is supplied to the customers, it won't be accepted by them. So it's in a way it's supply chain place.
Okay. Any idea about what is purchase order?
Purchase order is it depends on the retailers place them with the, I think retailers place them with the distributors to have the demanded product, and the also the manufacturers have with the suppliers to have the product to be purchased.
Okay. Shahzad, please.
Yes, Miss Hani, why you have chosen supply chain management?
I have chosen supply chain management because it consists of different processes, and like procurement management, inventory management, logistics management, and also it is the emerging field in Pakistan and is considered to be new, and that's and it, it, it the, due to the, its processes, it interests me a lot.
And you have an experience, you have written that you have done an internship in human resource department. So
yes.
What do you have learned from in this internship?
Well, my experience in the HR department in DHA head office was quite satisfactory. And over there, the subject that we that I have learned in the courses that we learned in the in our university and our course, the theory and the concepts, I was able to experience and view them practically. And the things that I learned, the process of training, the hirings, mostly the process of job posting was mostly done over there, and different documentation like minute sheet and like viewing the resumes. So such processes, I was able to view them practically and learn them.
Okay, you have written that evaluating different resume. How you evaluate them, differentiate them?
Well, it was we were under the supervision of the in DHA head office. We were in the supervision of our head. So he for that we had to first of all, we have to see the education background, that what education background was they had, and according to that we were distributing. If some people had had the majors in supply chain, they were being selected for the supply chain field, and some if the people had the background with HR, they would they were being selected for the HR department.
Okay, so what is job analysis? Do you know about this
job analysis? Yes. Job analysis is something is to see whether the it's a process of seeing if evaluating the person for the particular job that they are applying.
Okay. And have you ever heard about position recognition? Position requisition.
Position requisition, I have heard about it, and it's about people who work as a position recruiter, I think so. They select the people working, and they guide the people working under them, and provide them the positions that they are suitable for the.
Okay, so what do you think about HR comparing to supply chain?
I think HR is more into managing of the people, and supply chain is more into managing of the processes as HR is basically the part of it is basically managing the people's matters related to their job, their salary, their performance, and supply chain is more getting the product to the customers.
Okay, Ms. Hani, thank you so much. Thank you for your
thank
time.
Thank you so much.
All right, Hani, thank you. Take care. Lafiz.
Lafiz.
All right, so we have last candidate who was our moderator as well, Jahangir. So he's the last candidate as well.
Should we join back again? Because we only have like 5 minutes left on this meeting.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Yeah, please.
The ones I'm currently enrolled in, I have got to know a lot that has been happening in supply chain, a lot of developments that have been taking place, ever since a lot of years, and there has been a lot of recent developments as well. Moreover, there has been a lot of significant developments in Pakistan in the field of supply chain recently. So this field has really taken my interest.
You have taken different courses of supply chain. So tell me something, what did you learn in total quality management and Lean Six Sigma?
All right. So Lean Six Sigma was all about how to remove defects, how to, make your processes defects free, and rather, regardless of the fact that your business is product oriented or service oriented, your processes should be defect free. And we learned the concept of seven sins over there. And in those seven sins, waste and defects were actually pointed out as one of the main problems for any organization. And if any organization is able to eradicate these factors, they will thrive. And, reading a lot of case studies of some of the global organizations that have been doing really well, they were able to, eradicate these issues, and they were able to incorporate the concepts of Lean Six Sigma. Coming over to total quality management. Now, total quality management has its immense importance for any organization. And the matter of quality, the matter of, bringing in systems that enhance the level of quality, that enhance the processes for any organization, has been very important. And, when we come to quality management, we have seen Japan as a prime example for this. Japan was, they saw a huge devastation at the hands of other countries, America in particular, in World War II. And then we also saw them becoming one of the leaders in the world in a very short while. So, they were actually incorporating all the principles and theories of total quality management in their organizations. There were people like Denim and Juran, and these people, introduced so many theories and concepts of total quality management, which are also used by all these global organizations. And fortunately, these are also used by, organizations in Pakistan, in particular, the Artistic Denim Mills. I was just reading their company, your company portfolio and your company profile. And I was, very much, impressed by the fact that the company has been working a lot towards improving their quality, their processes, and the company has been integrating their processes. They have been incorporating different practices, different very recent and technological practices to improve their production levels.
So what do you think the supply chain process that we follow at our company?
Okay, so I really did not get to know a lot of the supply chain process.
Just a vague idea that you have.
Yeah, so this company is vertically integrated, which was written in the company portfolio. And any company that is vertically integrated has, significantly and successfully reduced a lot of their expenses, a lot of their costs, because they are their own suppliers. They are providing themselves with raw material. They don't have to be dependent on others. And, this is actually a very big advantage for any firm. If they don't have to depend on any supplier or any other firm to, supply them raw materials, there are so many external factors that can, hinder your processes. Moreover, the company goes through a process of, there are three things that were outlined, the spinning, weaving, dyeing, and finishing. And Okay, so there were a lot of technological and, you know, technical terms involved over there as well, which I'm not very much accustomed with. But, you know, there were a lot of machineries and a lot of sustainable practices as well. Okay, just to add to that, we have been, you know, studying a lot about green sustainability, green supply chains, how organizations can, you know, incorporate practices to, you know, be more eco-friendly, be more environmentally good. And to my surprise, I mean, it's just a sad thing to know that a lot of organizations in Pakistan aren't, you know, practicing green supply chains, but this particular organization, they are actually playing their part. So they are doing all they can to, you know, clean the water, clean the chemicals, recycling. And there has been a lot of things that have been happening over here to, you know, improve the green supply chain.
Okay, that's great. Shahzad, please.
Yes, Mr. Jangir. Yes, sir. Artistic Dynamics में एक new sector start किया है supply chain में. उसके बारे में आपको पता है?
Sir, can you please repeat your question?
Recently, supply chain start किया हमने.
Supply chain हमने एक recycling start किया in supply chain. कुछ information है आपको इसके बारे में?
Not in particular, no, sir.
अच्छा एक सेकंड जनरेशन हमने स्टार्ट की है जिसमें जो यूज डेनम होती है या रिजेक्टेड डेनम होती है उसको हमने रीयूटिलाइज सेकंड लाइफ में लेकर आए हम लोग उसको दोबारा बनाते हैं एक मतलब सेकंड जनरेशन सप्लाई चेन किया है कुछ इंफॉर्मेशन है इसके बारे में
नो आई डोंट नो अबाउट दिस
ठीक है जिस तरह आप बात कर रहे थे कि ग्रीनरी के बारे में ग्रीन एनवायरमेंट के बारे में तो हम लोग जैसे एनवायरमेंट को खराब हो रहा होता है एनवायरमेंट के वेस्टेज हो रहे होते हैं प्रोडक्ट्स जो है डिफेक्टिव प्रोडक्ट्स हैं जो कि जाया हो रहे होते हैं तो हमने उसको रीयूज करने के लिए स्ट्रेटेजी यूज की सप्लाई चेन में कि जो प्रोडक्ट्स बन के खराब हो जाते हैं या बाजार से रिजेक्टेड होते हैं तो हम उसको रिसाइकिल कर रहे होते हैं ठीक है तो एक न्यू स्ट्रेटेजी हमने यहाँ लॉन्च किया हमारे पास एडीएम में जो कि सप्लाई चेन में एक सेकंड जनरेशन के नाम से यूज हुआ है अच्छा दूसरी चीज मुझे ये बताइए कि आप SEOHub.PK के co-founder हैं
यस यस सो दिस हैपेंस टू बी माय फैमिली बिजनेस एंड इट्स माय ऑडिबल
हां एग्जैक्टली
Yes, so this happens to be my family business and so we started up this digital marketing agency and I mean I'm not as a permanent worker over there I'm working over there until my graduation. I'm over there as a content writer. I have been doing content writing for a while now. I was working as a freelancer previously since like 4 years. And then I came up to this digital marketing agency and I've learned SEO over there as well, along with a little bit of web designing and web development to, you know, add to my CV.
ओके सो अभी आप यहां पे क्या कंट्रीब्यूशन दे रहे हैं क्या काम कर रहे हैं यहां पे आप SEOHub.PK में
अच्छा करंटली आई एम अ कंटेंट राइटर ओवर देयर एंड आई एम आल्सो हैंडलिंग द मैटर्स ऑफ SEO ओवर देयर एज वेल सर्च इंजन ऑप्टिमाइजेशन
ओके सो हु इज लीडिंग मार्केटिंग ओवर देयर इन SEO मार्केटिंग एंड सप्लाई चेन
लीडिंग इन सप्लाई चेन
या सप्लाई चेन एंड लॉजिस्टिक SEOHub not logistic but supply chain
I don't understand your question actually you know
actually this is an organization that provides services am I right
yes exactly
okay
and you know this service is all about how any website can you know rank on the top of a search engine so
so your specialization in supply chain or marketing
supply chain management sir
supply chain and you have done research on application of artificial intelligence so what is the conclusion of this what you got from this
all right so my research was actually conducted on you know textile industry so this happens to be a very fortunate thing for me that people from the textile industry are interviewing me right now so I conducted this research for the textile industry of Pakistan and I you know went on to explore how artificial intelligence big data and the industry 4 all of these concepts all of these you know machine learning can actually help the textile industry to improve to thrive and to you know improve their production improve their improve in all the aspects. And then in my research, I looked upon the work, I looked upon the results of a lot of global organizations, a lot of textile industries that have been operating on at a global level, and they have been doing really well. And the reason being, they were incorporating artificial intelligence in their systems, they were using big data, and they were using it very well. And the whole crux of my research was to, you know, show how these organizations, the global ones, are doing well because of artificial intelligence, and how this can be mapped onto the textile industry of Pakistan in order to improve our industry. And the results of my research, you know, we conducted a survey and we ran all the test results on SPSS, it's a software, and we found out results through regression and correlation. And my research showed that there has been a very significant impact of artificial intelligence on all the various areas of supply chain management, naming product delivery, demand forecasting, planning, and all these areas can be significantly improved. Through this was shown through empirical evidence that all these areas can be improved if artificial intelligence is rightly incorporated into the systems of textile industry in Pakistan.
In Pakistan, okay. Acha, as considering to warehouse mein do method use kiye ja rahe hain, like LIFO and FIFO mostly.
Yes.
ठीक है. हम कौन सा method use कर रहे हैं, कुछ idea है आपको इस बारे में?
Sir, yes. You mainly use LIFO system, the last in first out.
Reason?
Excuse me.
Reason? Can I know the reason why we are using this strategy instead of FIFO?
It's mostly because of the products, the type of product that you're dealing with. So, for instance, if a new clothing material has been introduced and it's more about the industry, the fashion industry, it runs on the whole concept of what's in the trend, what's in the market right now. So for instance, if a whole batch of products were made in November, for instance, and they have been in the industry, they have been in the warehouse, and they haven't been sold as of yet, and now you have come up with a new batch in January, which is very recent, and those products, those clothes are, you know, of the recent trends, of the recent fashion, you would want them to reach the markets, to reach the customers, so that, you know, you stay relevant.
But I want a maximum profit from my products. So purane products mein se mujhe milega ya naye products mein se mujhe zyada profit milega?
I would like to believe that you'd earn more profit if you were to, you know, sell off your newer products, the newer inventory,
newer products.
Yes.
पुराने प्रोडक्ट से नहीं मिलेगा मुझे प्रॉफिट ज्यादा?
पुराने नहीं, पुराने प्रोडक्ट से भी मिलेगा आपको. और
हाई प्रॉफिट चाहिए मुझे. आई वांट अ हाई प्रॉफिट. मेरे पास बैच एक तैयार हुआ है नवंबर में, जो क्या बता रहे हैं नवंबर फॉर एग्जांपल, और काफी क्वांटिटी है, लेकिन कोविड की वजह से इंटरनेशनल मार्केट डिस्टर्ब है. ठीक है, एक्सपोर्टिंग कंट्री है, एक्सपोर्टिंग कंपनी है, हम लोग एक्सपोर्ट नहीं कर पाए, और अब दोबारा ट्रेडिंग स्टार्ट हुई है. तो अब हम नवंबर का प्रोडक्ट्स को हम लोग प्रेफर करेंगे, या हम लोग जनवरी के प्रोडक्ट जो मैन्युफैक्चर कर रहे हैं करंट, उसको प्रेफर करेंगे, और हमें मैक्सिमम प्रॉफिट चाहिए, कौन सा करेंगे आप?
सर, आई थिंक आप जनवरी वाले प्रोडक्ट्स को प्रेफर करेंगे.
जनवरी को करेंगे?
यस.
आपको नहीं लगता जनवरी में जो प्रोडक्ट्स, जो रॉ मटेरियल्स में लगा होगा, उसके प्रोडक्ट ज्यादा, उसकी प्राइस ज्यादा होंगे, और कॉस्टिंग प्रोडक्ट के ऊपर ज्यादा हो चुकी होगी, और प्रॉफिट कम हो चुका होगा?
सो यस, दिस इज द थिंग ऑफ दिस इंडस्ट्री नाउ. यू नो, देयर आर सम ट्रेड ऑफ्स दैट यू विल हैव टू डील विद नाउ दैट यू नो देयर आर सम एक्सटर्नल फैक्टर्स दैट वी कांट कंट्रोल. फॉर इंस्टेंस, अभी आपने ये ट्रेड बैरियर का नाम लिया था कि वो इंटरनेशनल मार्केटिंग जो है वो रुक गई थी. सो अब इस तरह के एक्सटर्नल फैक्टर्स जो है हम लोग रोक नहीं सकते. नाउ वी ऑल वांट टू यू नो मैक्सिमाइज अवर प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी, बट यू नो वी आल्सो वांट टू यू नो प्रोवाइड द हाईएस्ट लेवल ऑफ क्वालिटी. वी आल्सो वांट टू प्रोवाइड न्यूअर आइटम्स इनटू द मार्केट टू यू नो सैटिस्फाई अवर कस्टमर बेस, राइट? सो यू विल सेल ऑफ, यू विल प्रोवाइड इन द मार्केट टू द पीपल द प्रोडक्ट्स दैट आर मोर रेलेवेंट, द प्रोडक्ट्स दैट आर मोर ट्रेंडी राइट नाउ. You might want to, you know, hurt a little bit of your profit in that regard, but you'll succeed.
ठीक है, अच्छा, तो पुराने पुराने प्रोडक्ट्स जो हैं, ठीक है, जो हमारे पास स्टॉक में हमारे पर रह जाएंगे, उसका हम क्या करेंगे?
हाँ, आपने अभी वो अपना एक कॉन्सेप्ट पूरा वो मुझे समझाया था रिसाइकलिंग वाला, कि किस तरह आप अपनी डेनिम जीन्स को वापस से यूज करते हैं और वापस से उसको बना के आप लोग सेल ऑफ करते हैं. तो नाउ दैट यू आर यूजिंग दिस, आई बिलीव यू विल बी वेरी सक्सेसफुल.
थैंक यू जहांगीर.
थैंक यू.
यू आर वेलकम.
थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू.
खुदा हाफिज.
खुदा हाफिज.
थैंक यू सो मच तहसीन.
ऑलराइट, थैंक यू सो मच बोथ ऑफ यू फॉर बीइंग हियर, लाइक गिविंग टाइम फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स. और आपने उनको एक पूरा एक मतलब एक पूरा एक उनको एक आइडिया दिया कि हाउ दे हैव टू टैकल. और तकरीबन आपने आई गेस सारे ही क्वेश्चंस रेलेवेंट टू दैट जो पूछे हैं. Thank you so much both of you for your time and for your like this as well.
No issues. I'll be sharing the marks with you very soon. Hopefully by the end of today. Okay.
Thank you so much. Take care.
Take care.
Dafis.